You know, it's interesting because Miami City Ballet is so big that in their world, these things aren't the biggest issues they're facing. It's the more medium-sized and smaller dance companies and the choreographers that are living and working here now that really felt the impact of this, of the lack of coverage. And our view of creating a vibrant arts community is that that vibrancy has to exist at all levels, right? So it's not just the major flag bearer for dance, but it's got to be an infrastructure of dancers and choreographers and small and medium-sized companies that serve as a way to incubate talent here and incubate audience interest in the dance form as well. So in each of the disciplines, that's the approach that we take, which is top-to-bottom approach or bottom-to-top approach. Make sure that we're encouraging and supporting the arts at every level of its growth. And this strategy emerges out of my days in art school, where I shared studios with people who, 1 year, the work was nothing. They were collaging dead chickens on canvases. And the next year, they were painting brilliant paintings. And it was the realization that with the right kind of support and cultivation, work grows and it becomes better. And what you have to do in my job is make sure you're creating an environment where that can happen.